Hello everyone, today we are gonna study modal verb should, which is used in different situations and circumstances. So the first situation is when we express something that is probable. That means जब किसी चीज के होने की संभावना होती है, that means कि किया जाना चाहिए या हो जाना चाहिए, तो ऐसे sentences के साथ हम should का use करते हैं. For example, Suhail should be here by 2 p.m. That means Suhail 2 बजे तक यहाँ पर होना चाहिए. तो इस sentence के अंदर एक probability है, एक संभावना है, तो ऐसे sentence हम should से बनाते हैं. So the situation number second is when we ask a question. Yes, that means so many question can be asked by using should modal verb. For example, should we throw a surprise party for John? That means क्या हमें John के लिए एक surprise party throw करनी चाहिए? और the example number second, should I open a new shop? That means क्या मुझे एक नई दुकान खोल लेनी चाहिए? And the situation number third is when we show obligation, give recommendation or even an opinion. That means जब हम जिम्मेदारी की बात करते हैं, किसी को कुछ चीज़ recommend करते हैं या हम अपना opinion किसी को देते हैं, ऐसी situations के अंदर भी हम should modal verb का use कर सकते हैं. For example, example number first is you should stop eating fast food. That means तुम्हें fast food खाना छोड़ देना चाहिए. अभी एक recommendation भी हो सकता है, this can be an opinion as well. And the second example is He should forget his past. That means this is an opinion कि उसे अपना past, उसे अपना बीता हुआ कल भूल जाना चाहिए. And now let's learn how to form affirmative sentences. For creating an affirmative sentence, first of all, one has to put subject, then should, then first form of the verb, and then object. So the example number first is, you should be careful about your health. That means तुम्हें अपनी health के बारे में careful होना चाहिए या रहना चाहिए. Example number second is we should meet once in a week. That means हमें हफ्ते में एक बार मिल लेना चाहिए. And example number three is Salman should work harder to score better marks. That means Salman को और ज़्यादा मेहनत करनी चाहिए अच्छे marks हासिल करने के लिए. So now let's move on to negative sentences. For creating a negative sentence, first of all one has to put subject, then should, then not, then first form of the verb, and then object, and then full stop. So the number first example is Aman should not disobey his parents. That means Aman ko apne parents ko disobey nahi karna chahiye. Obey means hota hai agya manna, disobey means hota hai agya na manna. And the second example is I should not waste more time of mine. That means mujhe apna aur zyada samay बर्बाद नहीं करना चाहिए. एंड द एग्जाम्पल नंबर थर्ड इज करण शुड नॉट स्किप वर्किंग आउट ड्यूरिंग द लॉकडाउन. दैट मीन्स करण को लॉकडाउन के दौरान अपना वर्कआउट, दैट मीन्स अपनी कसरत नहीं छोड़नी चाहिए. And now let's move on to interrogative sentences. For creating an interrogative sentence, first of all, one has to put should, and then subject, and then first form of the verb, and then object, and then question mark. So the first example is, should I say sorry first? That means, क्या मुझे sorry पहले कह देना चाहिए? And the example number second is, should Anuj forgive Rahul? यानी क्या Anuj को Rahul को माफ कर देना चाहिए? And the third example is, should I upload this picture on Facebook? That means, क्या मुझे ये पिक्चर फेसबुक पर अपलोड कर देना चाहिए? And now finally let's move on to interrogative negative sentences. For creating an interrogative negative sentence, first of all you have to put should, then subject, then not, then first form of the verb, and then object, and then question mark. So the example number first is should you not wake up early in the morning? That means kya tumhe subah jaldi nahi uthna chahiye? And the number second is should you not complete your homework daily? That means kya tumhe apna homework daily complete nahi karna chahiye? And number third is should you not be more careful in future? That means क्या तुम्हें भविष्य में ज़्यादा सतर्क या सावधान या careful नहीं होना चाहिए? And I hope you understood. Have a great time ahead.